Welcome to Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart and this video is sponsored by Kingston. They provided four 480 gigabyte SSDs for my server build, so a really big thank you to Kingston. In this video I'm gonna explain why I need four SSDs in my server build and how I'm gonna use them with ZFS. Here we have the four SSDs. We have two Kingston UV500. They are consumer / business SSDs. And we have two DC500Ms, and they are enterprise / server SSDs, and all the drives are 480 gigabyte each. So let's talk about the UV500 SSD. They are 2.5 inch, 7mm height, so it fits in any laptop. They are SATA 3, 6 gigabits per second. The capacity is 120, 240, 480, 916 and 920 gigabytes. The NAND is 3D TLC and the life expectancy is 1 million hours before failure, and you got a limited 5-year warranty. And the price of the UV500 480 gigabyte is now in the Netherlands 64 euros each. So now the Kingston Data Center DC500 Enterprise Solid State Drives. This is the M version and it's optimized for mixed use applications, so read and write. You also have the R version that's optimized for read intensive applications. And the DC500 has a really nice function that is onboard PLP, power loss protection. So there's a super cap inside of the SSDs, and not many SSDs have a super cap. And the drive is quite affordable for 132 euros each. And the form factor is 2.5 inch, 7mm height. It's also a SATA 3 6 gigabit per second SSD. And the capacities are 480 gigabyte, 960 gigabyte, 1.92 terabyte and 3.84 terabyte. And the NAND is 3D TLC. And you have 5 years warranty on this SSD and it is rated for 2 million hours. So let's take a look at the server what we have right now. We have a 3U chassis with a 6.8 terabyte SAS hard drive from Seagate. We have a Tyan Dual Socket 2011 server motherboard with two Xeon E5s, so 6 core 2 GHz with hyperthreading. We have 120 GB of DDR3 memory. The motherboard has two SATA 600 ports and four SATA 300 ports. Here we have an IBM M1015 SAS controller with cables to the front backplanes. And here we have a Solar Flare 10 gig network card. And right now in this drive bay there are two laptop hard drives installed for my test installation of Progmox. Progmox is the OS where I can do VMs and run ZFS, and it is a Linux distribution, so I can do anything I want on it. So I have really a lot of flexibility to do my own configuration. So in this drive bay I will install the two UV500 SSDs to the SATA 600 ports on the motherboard for booting and for the VMs. And the DC500 SSDs goes here in the front together with the SAS 8TB drives connected to the M1015 controller, and that two drives will be the L2 ARC cache of ZFS. So this is my server, and I duct taped the SSDs to my whiteboard because they are pretty lightweight, so no worries. So this is the server. We have two CPUs with 8 memory sticks, 120 gigabyte DDR3, the SATA ports on the motherboard, IBM controller with the 8 SAS ports, and here we have the chassis with all the hot swappable drive bays. So in the drive bays we have 8 terabyte disks, and they are running at 7200 RPM. And the hard drives are connected with two cables on the SAS ports through the M1015. One cable per four hot swappable drive bays. So my plan is to take the two UV500 drives and I will mirror them with ZFS. And this will be the boot drives, OS and VMs. I will connect those two SSDs to the SATA 600 ports on the motherboard with direct SATA cables. The way I designed the server, that anything can fail, but I still have my data. That's the most important thing. So a hard drive can fail, the RAID controller can fail, the motherboard can fail, the SSDs can fail, but I still don't lose my data because I can take my drives out of this system, put it in another system and have my data. So the drives are the most important thing in the system. So the rest can of course fail. So why did I choose for the UV500 SSDs? They are pretty cheap. They are for booting and the OS, that's not a heavy load. And the VMs are for a test lab situation, PFSense, maybe a Windows installation to live stream, stuff like that, but not a heavy load or a big server load with hundreds of clients. So these two drives will be fine, and if a drive fails, they will run in a mirror, so no worry that I lose the data or the OS. So this is why I chose affordable SSDs for the boot drive. So now let's talk about the 480 gigabyte DC500 drives. How I gonna use them? I gonna put them here in the drive base. So this will be a 480 gigabyte SSD. And I gonna partition them and I gonna use them as 2x400 gigabyte as L2 arc. And that will be in a stripe. So I have 800 gigabyte of SSD cache. Also, I'm gonna put the SIL S-log on here, also in a partition, probably 2x20 gigabyte, but I'm not an expert yet in the SIL S-log, so I need to figure it out, but because they have the super caps inside, they are especially really good for SIL. And the other option with super caps is with Intel SSDs, and there are not many brands that has super caps inside for data protection. So this is a big bonus of the DC500 drives, and they are pretty affordable for 132 euros each here in the Netherlands. Also, the DC500s are good for 24/7 operation with a much heavier load than the UV500s. Also, the IOPS of the DC500 is higher, and for the DC500M, the 480 gigabyte is 9800 read and 5800 write. And if we look at the UV500 IOPS, 9700 read and 3500 write. So the DC500 has much better IOPS performance than the UV500, and the sequential read write is 520/500 for the UV500 and 555/520 for the DC500M. So as you can see, the DC500 Enterprise drive has much better performance on paper than the UV500 drive. So let's write out storage configuration. So we have the boot, two drives of 480 gigabyte in a mirror, but I don't gonna use the full 480 gigabyte. I gonna make a smaller partition, because when you over-provisionize your SSD, you have a much longer life out of it, and the performance will stay much better if you don't partition the whole drive. So I will probably end up with a 420 gigabyte partition. So we have a 420 gigabyte mirror for the OS and the VMs. So now let's talk about the hard drives and the SSD cache. So we have 6x8 terabyte SAS, 7200 RPM, and they will run in a RAID. And a RAID set 2 is like a RAID 6. So two drives can fail. So the total storage is 48 terabyte, but because of the redundancy of two drives, this will be raw storage, and we have 32 terabyte usable. And I really suck in writing on a whiteboard. So on the RAID set 2, I will put extra L2 arc cache, and that will be 2 times 400 gigabyte of the DC500Ms, and they will be in a stripe. I will have 800 gigabyte of cache, and it will be running like 1000 plus megabyte per second. So I can fully saturate my 10 gigabit network with this configuration. So also on the RAID set 2, I will put the sale / slog, and it will be 220 gigabyte in a mirror. It's not really a traditional write cache, but it helps with write performance. But please look this up. I have not much experience with it to explain it to you. But this is the plan. And because of the super cap, the DC500 is really good for the SIL solution. And you will also want to have your server on UPS for the best data safety. The way how the read cache works. So ZFS automatically copies the files that you use the most to the L2R cache on the two SSDs in a stripe. But the stripe is not a problem, because when this will crash, the data is still in the RAID set 2. And also the memory of your system will be used for cache. And this is like the L1 cache. So also the most used data will be copied in the main memory. So this is your L1 cache. This is your L2 cache, and your data is safe on the RAID set 2. So ZFS is a really strong file system. If one of the items will fail, you don't have a data loss. So if you have a fire, a flooding, lightning strikes or theft, of course your data will be gone. So you always need to have a backup, and the best backup is an offsite backup. Make backups, but the system is so strong that normal failures will not affect your data set that it's unreadable. So the OS that I'm going to use with ZFS is Procmox, and is Debian based. And the nice thing about Procmox that it is a full Linux OS. So you can do anything that you want. You can install all packages. You have no restriction. After reboot, all the packages are still there. You can make your own scripts on the console. You can SSH into your system. So you have much more control about your system than with like a free NAS. And Procmox is made for VMs. And for the file server part, I'm just gonna configure it by hand, just with install Samba, install NFS, just by hand. I don't need any tools for it, because it's just a basic Linux OS, and I don't need much share. So once I set up my shares, how I have it now, I will be done with it. And I'm just gonna use the VM function of Procmox to test things out. But the base system will be just configured out of the console. I hope you have now a better understanding how I gonna build my file server in terms of the storage, and how I gonna use the SSDs in it, how I gonna use the hard drives in combination with the SSDs and the memory for cache and the whole system. I'm probably a really bad teacher. So if you have any questions, please leave them down below in the comments, and I will try to answer them, or send you to an article that explains something better. So now the only thing left to do is install the SSDs in the server, and this is getting really heavy, but I need to make a thumbnail. So let's replace the current two hard drives that are in here. I use them for a test configuration to try out Procmox, and they are old laptop hard drives. So the SSDs are much faster and much more reliable. So it's now time to install the DC500Ms in the hot swappable base. The problem with the brackets in this server, there are no holes in here for SSDs. So I need to find a way to mount it. But luckily I have a solution. I have this bracket from Dell and that mimics a hard drive and fits the SSD in place. And I bought them in the Netherlands and I have the tweakers.net link in the description. You can send Hardware Junk a message. And maybe he has some more of them. Otherwise, you can find them on eBay for pretty cheap. So I have a bag of screws. And I magnetized my screwdriver. Let's see. Line up the holes. So now the SSD is mounted on this frame. So we can drop it in the hot swappable tray. And move it to the right position. I don't have holes here in the side of the tray to put in screws, so the SSD is only screwed down on this side. But the other nice function of this bracket is that it mimics a hard drive. So if you have it here, it has an even airflow over all the drives. So let's try to fit it. So let's do the other drive. So all the storage is now installed in the system. The only part that I'm still waiting for is the I/O shield. So if I cut the I/O shield in, I will take out the motherboard, install the I/O shield, and then I will do all the cable management of the system. And I will remove the mid fan bar here, or fan tray here. And I'm gonna modify them so the Noctua fans will be installed in here. Because now the fans are hitting a connector in the bottom. So I gonna remove the connectors and I gonna screw down the fans to here so they will be permanent in place and then the top can be closed. But let's try out the SSDs. Okay, the Kingston SSDs are detected. And also the other two Kingston SSDs are detected. Let's install Procmox. Welcome to Procmox Virtual Environment. And the installation is pretty straightforward. Only I want to have a custom hard drive configuration. So let's select the SSD that I want. Then go to options. Set FS RAID 1. Deselect all the drives that I don't want to use. All the 8TB. The Kingston DC500. Also deselect the USB stick, so we only have the two Kingston SUV500. Let's go to advanced. And here by the hard drive size we're gonna fill in 400. So we're gonna over-professionalize the SSDs and don't use the whole drive. That's better in the long run. Netherlands, Europe. Procmox is installed and here you see the IP address where you can log in and continue the configuration, and also you have a full console here to do your own custom configuration. So let's see if it detected all the hard drives. So we have an SDA A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I and then the partitions. And as you can see, it made a partition of 400 GB. So we have 47 GB free on the two boot SSD for over-professionalizing. And here you can see that we have the free space. All the CPUs are detected. We have a lot of memory and not much in use. So the Kingston SSDs are installed. it was pretty straightforward. I used two of the UV500 drives and two of the DC500M drives. If you want to pick them up, you can use my Amazon affiliated links down in the description, and that will help my channel out without costing you extra money. A really big thank you to Kingston for sponsoring the SSDs for my server build. I really appreciate it. And with this machine with dual CPU, a lot of memory, a lot of storage, really nice SSDs and 10 gigabit network, I really have a high performance server which keeps my data really safe, and I will of course make a backup server to backup all the data of this machine. Thanks for watching, and if you like to support me, I have Patreon, I have Amazon affiliated links, I have Twitter, and you can join Retro Machines on Facebook.